Good morning, Girl Power Gators. I'm Kamari. Today's October 28th, 2020. Please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Congratulations to our iReady High Flyers from last week. Most lessons passed with the highest grade. For reading, they are kindergarten, Drayton C with 91% accuracy. First grade, Abby K with 100% accuracy. Second grade, Jade Carter with 97% accuracy. Third grade, Wyatt K with 79% accuracy. Fourth grade, Gin M with 83% accuracy. From fifth grade, Jason C with 82% accuracy. Sixth grade, Julian L with 98% accuracy. From math, we have kindergarten, Zayden H with 100% accuracy. First grade, Olivia A with 96% accuracy. Second grade, Caleb A with 100% accuracy. Third grade, Mark L with 88% accuracy. Fourth grade, Marquez C with 92% accuracy. Fifth grade, Kobe W with 98% accuracy. Sixth grade, Aiden R with 96% accuracy. Now here's our OCL crew with lunch and weather.
Today we'll have a high of 86 and a low of 73 degrees. We can expect clear skies today as well as a waxing gibbous moon tonight. For today lunch, we have pizza or turkey and cheese sandwiches. Now it's time for the Daily Republic service announcement.
Mother Necessity with her good intentions. Where would this country be without her inventions?
Oh, things were rotten in the land of cotton until Whitney made the cotton gin. Now old times there will soon be forgotten, for it did the work of 100 men.
Mother Necessity, where would we be?
Mother Edison worked late each night. It went well until the fading light.
Little Thomas Alva Edison said, I'll grow up to be a great inventor, and I'll make a lamp to help my mommy see. Wowee, what an excellent application of electricity.
He worked hard and pulled a switch. He was smart and very rich.
Mother Necessity, help us to see.
Now the mother of Samuel Morse always sent the lad out on a horse.
Whoopee, take a message to Miss Peavy on the far side of the pike. Spread the word about the quilting bee next Saturday night.
Little Samuel started thinking of a way to send a message, though he'd never met a horse he didn't like.
Mother Necessity.
Elias, can you help me with my sewing?
Mother dear, I'll fulfill your fondest wishes.
Elias, how?
This machine I've made will keep your sewing really flowing. In fact, we'll keep the whole nation in stitches.
Ah, Mother Necessity, where would we be?
Bring me on the Alexander Graham Bell. Thank you, Alexander, for the phone. Unless I had a telephone.
Mother Necessity.
Orville, Wilbur, go outside this minute and now continue with your silly playing. Take these players and take those blueprints. Take that funny looking thing. Take that wheel and take that wing. I can't hear a thing that Mrs. Johnson's saying. Orville, Wilbur, a night boy.
Orville, Mother Necessity, where would we be?
When Robert Fulton made the steamboat go.
When Marconi gave us wireless radio.
When Henry Ford cranked up his first auto.
When Samuel Slater showed us how the factories go.
When Robbie Iron and Ollie Collins, Gil and Yankee, don't you know that
they made this country really grow, 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 grow. With Mother Necessity, and where would we be?
progeny.
With Lego.
A brand new